Okay, students, now today we are going to start with the high scoring topic of D&F block, that is potassium dichromate. Okay, Q&A session, question and answer session, along with proper explanation. What type of question comes from this inorganic topic and how you have to deal with them, we are going to discuss, and we are going to study only in the examination point of view. Okay, only in the examination point of view only we are going to study. Okay, so let's start with the K2Cr2O7. The very first question, what is the ore? Okay, from where we can prepare, what that is chrome ore. What ore it is prepared? Chrome ore. Chrome ore is basically mixed oxide, basically mixed oxide of iron and chromium. Okay, so FeCr2O4, what is the formula? FeCr2O4. The very first question comes from the potassium dichromate. As per the NCRT, it is ore from which it is prepared is FeCr2O4. Okay, do you understand? Now this is also called as FeCr2O4 is also called as, good, it is also called as chromite ore, CHROMITE, chromite ore. Okay, and the question will be how many steps involved in the, how many steps are involved in the preparation of potassium dichromate? Okay, how many steps are involved in potassium dichromate from the chromite ore? So how many steps you will write? How many steps? Okay,
3 steps.
Good. So there are 3 steps. So, but to confuse you all, I have written only 2 steps, but there will be 3 steps. In that steps also, how the question comes, this is given in NCRT, but from this NCRT statements only how the questions will be arising. Okay, so like potassium chromite ore when treated with alkaline oxidation, it is oxidized in which medium? Alkali medium. Alkali medium means it should be basic medium. So this is NaOH, it is well known fact, but how come this Na2CO3 is also alkaline? Na2CO3 is also alkaline. Like these questions only, this is not out of the NCRT, this is not specially mentioned in NCRT, like that questions will be there inorganic. Okay, that's why Q&A session for inorganic topic is very important. If you go through just then you will not be able to solve the questions. So actually this is alkaline, this is basic in nature because Na2CO3 is a salt of strong base and weak acid. Strong base and weak acid. So it is a strong base. So resultant also will be basic, that is alkaline. Okay. So these are the 2 alkali medium used for oxidation of the chrome ore, conversion of chrome ore into sodium chromate. Okay. So for that, if you are using the NaOH, the additional product to memorize easily, additional product here, NaOH will give you the H2O, Na2CO3 will give you the CO2, and our aim is to replace the iron with the sodium. Okay, so our aim is now changed. Okay, here it is changed with, earlier it used to be sodium, now it is replaced, sorry, earlier it is used to be iron, now it has been replaced with the sodium. Okay, 1 mole of iron is replaced by the 2 mole of sodium. Is it understood? Now iron is eliminated as a ferric oxide. Iron will be eliminated as a ferric oxide. So the questions arising from this equation, is it understood? What will be the iron is removed as? So you should write it as a ferric oxide. What is the byproduct used when sodium hydroxide is prepared, used for this step? H2O. What is the byproduct produced when alkali medium is produced by the sodium carbonate? Answer is CO2. Like that internal way you should study. Is it understood? Now our aim is to separate this. This will be separated. Okay. Now the question, second step is conversion of sodium chromate. Our aim is to prepare sodium dichromate. Sorry, potassium dichromate. We reached only up to what stage? Chromate stage only. it is need to be converted into dichromate. For converting sodium chromate into sodium dichromate, we just use the sulfuric acid. Okay, so sodium chromate when treated with sulfuric acid will give you the sodium Na2Cr2O7 plus Na2SO4 plus H2O. Okay, so as a normal preparation method for up to mains purpose, up to small level exam like MCET state engineering examination, up to here it is okay. Now as an innovative way, the work question what they will ask, we want to prepare potassium dichromate and why you are using sodium. Question will be, why we are using, directly you reacted with the KOH K2CO3
more soluble.
Okay, so why we need to prepare, why we need to use sodium. Okay, so that question will be explained by any of you if you know.
Sir, sodium dichromate more soluble.
Okay, don't worry, I will be explaining it, don't worry. Okay, so here that first let us see here. So Na2Cr2O7 plus Na2SO4 plus H2O in the NCRT it is given, but not in the explanatory way. What is that? Here it is given that Na2SO4 is less soluble, hence it is left over as a crystal, collected as a crystal. Okay, so due to this less solubility, if I use K2 directly potassium, here K2SO4 will be formed. It is very difficult to separate both of them. Okay, that's why what we will do, first we will prepare, instead of potassium dichromate, we will prepare the sodium dichromate. Now sodium dichromate and sodium sulfate, there are difference in solubility. Due to difference in solubility, now we can separate them easily. After separating the, this is the two steps. Okay, so the third step is major step. First step we have done, chromate ore is converted into sodium chromate. Okay, second step, sodium chromate is converted into sodium dichromate, and third step we are going to convert sodium dichromate into potassium dichromate. Which chromate? Na2Cr2O7. Very simple method. See, 2 sodium is to be replaced, therefore 2 KCl is required. It is just a double displacement reaction. Okay, so double displacement reaction, very few people know that double displacement reaction does not involve any reactivity series. If suppose potassium is there, then it will replace or not, then we have to check, cross check with its reactivity. Okay, this should be more reactive than this, but in double displacement no such rule is applicable. Okay, so now what it will converted as, K2Cr2O7 plus and 2NaCl. So now finally in the step 3 we got what we require. Okay, this is how the questions comes from the preparation method. Okay, okay, now after the preparation, after the questions from the preparation method, now the questions are from the properties. Okay, so these are the some properties related questions which have already came, and based upon the questions which already came, these are the some equations you need to fill up. Okay, all are within the syllabus only, okay. So if you go through the line by line of the NCRT, all equations you can complete. Now you can complete on your own, then cross check. Okay, okay, tried, all of you tried. Now let us see what are, how many of them are correct. Self, you should do it on your own. Okay, so first reaction, potassium dichromate on heating gives converted, dichromate is converted to chromate along with the chromic anhydride. What is chromic anhydride? Cr2O3 is called as a chromic anhydride, and oxygen is liberated. Okay, second one is on reaction with KOH. On reaction with KOH, it gives K2CrO4, that is same potassium chromate plus H2O. Okay, then concentrated cold H2SO4 for different product, concentrated hot or on heating different product. What is the difference is when it is treated with the cold, it gives a important product CrO5. Okay, this is actually structure and everything is here, but questions are there in the 11th class redox reaction. Okay, CrO5 is butterfly structure. When you calculate oxidation number of chromium, you will get plus 10, but actually it is plus 6. Okay, so that is because of the peroxy linkage. Out of the five oxygens, all the five oxygens are not oxides. Four oxygens are peroxy oxide. This is peroxy, this is peroxy, this is peroxy, and this is also peroxy. And this is plus 2, this is minus 2. Okay, next. Hot and concentrated. It is simple reaction. There is not much to remember into it. K2SO4, see, everything is converted to sulfate. Potassium sulfate, chromium sulfate. Just easy to remember. That extra potassium dichromate is a oxygen rich compound. What compound? It is a oxygen rich compound. Okay, whenever it is heated, due to the presence of extra oxygen, it acts as an oxidizing agent. So this is proved over here also. And it oxidizes iodide, potassium iodide. Oxidation number is minus 1. Now it is converted to 0. Ferrous to ferric, chloride to chlorine. Okay, and even this chlorine will convert everybody into the chloride only. Okay, see, potassium also converted to potassium chloride, chromium also converted to chromium chloride. Same thing happened here also. Okay, so when you compare all together, that way you can easily remember. Okay, same thing happens here also. Sulfur dioxide, only thing is extra oxygen will not come. Already extra oxygen is here, but here it is not there. That's why this will be oxidized to potassium sulfate, chromium sulfate plus H2O. Okay, this reaction is carried out in acidic medium mostly, and HCl and H2SO4. This is most important, CrO to Cl2, what it is called as. Okay.
Chromyl chloride.
Okay, CrO to Cl2, this is one of the most important topic, chromyl chloride. What it is called as? Chromyl chloride, and it is used for testing the presence of. Actually, topic is here, the questions are there in the qualitative analysis. It is used to identify in the given salt whether chlorine minus is there or not, to test the presence of chloride. Chromyl chloride is used. Okay, what is the formula? CrO2 Cl2.
Cl2.
What is the formula? CrO2 Cl2. Sometimes they may ask structure also. Okay, so better to prepare in this direction. This is the tetrahedral structure. What is the structure? Tetrahedral structure. And how many sigma bonds and how many pi bonds? 4 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. Okay, so they are vapors. Chromyl chloride vapors will confirm the presence of chlorine. Again, to reconfirm, there is one more test, that vapors are passed through dash and dash is obtained. Okay, so normal people study up to here only. Sometimes they know that chromyl chloride is important, but why it is important, what type of question comes? Somebody will study, then up to what they will study, it is used for testing the presence of chloride. And but after that vapor comes, where they are sent, what is the color obtained? Okay, can you say? Okay, now listen, up to here if you study, then your preparation is incomplete. That chromyl chloride vapors are sent into NaOH. That chromyl chloride, for further confirmation that the vapors are chromyl chloride only, they are sent into what? NaOH. Then they will give you the yellow solution. Which solution? Yellow solution. This is the confirmatory test to, this is only preliminary test. Presence of the chromyl chloride vapors, only preliminary test. but it is further confirmed by passing the vapors through the NaOH, which will convert the solution into yellow color. The conversion into yellow color confirms the presence of chloride. Okay, most of the questions in the potassium dichromate is based upon its oxidizing property. Okay, so my suggestion is don't mug up the reactions. Okay, just fundamental two equations if you remember, then it will be easy to answer most of the question. Okay, when question is in ionic form, use this. When question is in molecular form, use this. Okay, so the oxidizing nature of potassium dichromate is due to evolution of how many? 3 moles of nascent oxygen. 1 mole of potassium dichromate can liberate 3 moles of oxygen, nascent oxygen. And already you must be knowing each oxygen oxidation number is normally -2. -2 into 3. So that is change will be 3. Change will be how much? 6. That's why equivalent factor can be explained on this terminology also. Equivalent factor of potassium dichromate is 6. Okay, and it works only in acidic medium. Only in which medium? Acidic medium. Okay, now the question is in ionic form, we don't know. Just they have mentioned, if they mention sulfuric acid, then this will be sulfate, this will be sulfate. If it is chloride, this is chloride, this is chloride, that extra oxygen will be given to the other person, like SO2, SO3, SO4 2-, like that. Okay, so Cr2O7, this is ionic equation. If nothing about the negative ion, let it be sulfate, let it be chloride, then this is a general equation. And now it is very easy. See, it is gaining, it is reducing by 6 electrons. 1 mole is reduced by 6 electrons. So this also proves that it is a equivalent factor is what? 6. Okay. So, and this is changing from the +6 to +3. Changing from +6 to +3. That is the oxidizing properties. By using these two equations, you can write most of the reactions. Okay. Mainly, you should remember equivalent factor of potassium dichromate is 6, and it acts as oxidizing agent only in acidic medium, especially sulfuric acid and hydrochloric acid, because they are not oxidizing in nature. If you use nitric acid itself also oxidizes. So, which oxidized and which is better, there is no confusion now. Okay. Now, the question is about the structure. Okay, we have studied about the preparation, we have studied about the properties. Now, main question will be of the structure. Okay, so Cr2O7, so 2 chromium are there. Okay, first we will try to give 3 oxygens each, but 1 oxygen is there common. Okay, so this will be the structure. Cr2O7 2-. Okay, this is minus, this is minus, and this is okay. Now, chlorine, chromium can have maximum how many unpaired? 6 unpaired. So it can have 6 bonds only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 bonds also completed. Now, there is no conjugation here, these two are equivalent bonds. Okay. Only 2 equivalent bonds which does not participate in resonance. Okay, do not participate in what? Do not participate in resonance. Is it understood? Now presently there is a single bond over here. So because of this, what happens? This will become single double bond and this will become single bond. After a certain time, this will become as a single bond. Like that, these three have equal chance. Similarly, these three also have equal chance. So these three and these three, total 6 identical bonds. How many bonds? 6 identical bonds which can participate in resonance. 2 identical bonds which cannot participate in resonance. Okay. Now the color. Okay, most important question is color. Okay, even though see all five electrons are participating in bond formation, all six electrons are participating in bond formation, hence they should not be colored, but they are colored due to charge transfer. What you will write reason? Charge transfer. Okay, this is so many times repeated question. The color of the potassium dichromate is due to DD transfer, due to presence of unpaired electron. Likewise, question will be there. So, but your answer must be, what should be your answer? Your answer must be the charge transfer. Where it is transferring? See, charge is transferring from oxygen to pi bond, and pi bond is charge transfer. Ultimately, charge is transferred from negative ion to metal, metal to again negative ion. Metal to where? Metal to negative ion and negative oxygen. Ion to metal. So that is the reason behind the potassium dichromate charge and structure. It is just two tetrahedrals combined together. How many combined together? Two tetrahedrals combined together. Okay. This is one tetrahedron. This is another tetrahedron. Two tetrahedron sharing one corners. Two tetrahedron sharing one corners. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.